Hello, everyone. So, I just finished the first stage of a leadership training, and I want to share my thoughts and my experience while it's still fresh. So, before I get into that, I would love for you guys to like just take a moment and imagine literally spending 3 full days, just you and your deepest, darkest, innermost, ugliest shit deep inside for 3 days. Imagine doing that. Just imagine 3 full days that you get to look head on with all of your deepest fears, all of your deepest pain, all of your deepest insecurities for 3 full days. Just take a moment and imagine what that would be like. And first of all, like, do you even have the courage to do that? I just went through that. I just went through 3 full days of really looking directly at what's really been holding me back, keeping me in my smallness, like looking at all of my shit and getting to own up to that, getting to take full responsibility for how everything in my life is a direct reflection of all the shit that's been inside of me. And I want to share with you guys a couple of things that really started to show up that just made me, everything is so crystal clear now for me, super crystal clear. And I want to share this because, like, in these past 3 days, one thing that I've discovered, one thing that I know for sure, is that deep down, beneath all of the masks that we put on, beneath all of the career paths that we have, beneath all of the money of the houses that we have, deep down, we are just all scared little children wanting to be loved, wanting to be seen, wanting to be acknowledged. And then we do so many things in our lives just to try to get that from someone, from the external circumstances. We want to get it from our partner. We want to get it from the money we make. We want to get it from the job that we have. We are seeking love and appreciation and being valued, being acknowledged, because we're hurting inside. I can say that it's a truth. I mean, that's a fact, unless you have done the inner work to really own up to what's the shit that's still bit that's running your life right now, right? So for me personally, I'm just still feeling a lot of the emotions because it's been such an intense 3 days. Oh my gosh, like I've been doing inner work for so long. Like, I've been doing it for 2+ years now, and there was still so much, and I know there's still so much shit that I get to own up to and I get to release. But a couple of things that got that shone a bright light upon are a couple patterns that I really have kind of picked up from childhood, growing up as a kid. And I noticed one thing about myself is that my voice has always been repressed, has always not I have always shut my voice down, because growing up as a little kid, being outspoken, speaking up and sharing my voice, sharing what I had to say, it got associated with pain, because I was super outspoken but my parents may have yelled at me. I was super outspoken. I was more outgoing, more outspoken than my twin sister. So my parents chose my twin sister over me. They favored her. And that created pain in my heart. And because I had created that story, that being outspoken, voicing up my opinions, speaking out equals being unloved, equals rejection, equals disapproval, that's been running my entire life. And I can guarantee you guys, there are something in you, right? We have 5% of our decisions that we make, 5% of our life is created by our conscious mind, right? We get to decide, this is what I want, this is what I want to create. But 95% underneath all of that is the junk. It's all of the limiting beliefs that we have picked up. It's all of the stories that we've been telling ourselves our whole entire freaking life. Like, I saw this. I saw this in my life in the past 3 days. I've been letting so many things that are not true been running my entire life. It's been telling me, like, I realized how much I believe that I didn't matter. I realized how much I believe that my voice didn't matter. I realized how much I didn't feel that I love myself because I never got that from people that I looked up to that were my caregivers, right? There's just so many stories that it's been internalized in a being, and that's been running your life. And how that started to show up in my life is that, first of all, money, and your money is a direct association between how much you believe you are, how valuable you are, how much worth do you have for yourself, right? So if you don't have money, then that means your self-worth is really low. And so that's been showing up, right? I have a lot of financial limitations because of that lack of self-belief, that lack of self-worth that stems from all the way as a childhood. And not speaking out, not fully expressing myself to everyone else. They don't get to see my full life because I associate it with fully expressing me to be, I'm gonna receive a negative consequence where I will receive pain. So that's shown up for me. Another thing that shown up for me was like, I have to put on this mask of masculinity to protect myself. Because growing up, my dad is kind of feminine, and I really got to look so deep, and I got to be stand in his shoes and really understand like what in his childhood that created the way that he's being. But that's, I'm not talking about that right now. I'm talking about me. So like I didn't have that masculine support like growing up my whole life, and I saw how my mom was never able to receive, like she never learned how to receive love, she never learned how to receive money, she never know how to receive support from another person. So I picked that pattern up, and my whole life I just always been like, I got this, like I'm doing it all myself. I didn't know how to receive anything. I didn't know how to receive intimacy. I didn't know how to receive money. I didn't know how to receive support. And that showed up in my relationship, in my romantic relationships, right? There is just so much that we get to look at, and there's just so much that we get to own up to. Like, this is just the beginning. What I just went through these past 3 days, like, it really just barely scratched the surface. It really shown so much pain that's been in my heart, that's been running my life, and I'm really ready to let it all go because that's really been stopping me from my next level, my next step of greatness. And I'm sharing this with you guys is because I want you to also think about in what ways in your life right now that you know that what I'm sharing is resonating with your heart in a deeper level, that you are letting something, a memory of the past or a pain from your childhood, that's still holding you back right now. It's still holding you back. Like, you know it. You know it deep down that you can do so much better. You know that you can create so much more. You know deep down that you have so much more potential. You don't need to stuck at the job that you hate. You don't need to be stuck at the relationship that you don't love. But why are you still choosing to be there? The why, it's unconscious. Until you shed awareness to why, that's why you're choosing to be there, it's gonna be forever a part of your story. It's gonna be a part of your being. So, I just wanna pop on here really quick to kinda share this experience. Did you just graduate at HCL Vision? Yes, I did, Daniela. Yeah, I think I saw you in graduation. So I did wanna share like what showed up for me. And I cannot wait for what's coming. Next week, I'm going to go back for the next stage of the leadership training. And I'm going to be a different person. I already know that. Like, there's just so much in me that I've been burying. And if you guys, like, see me and you think that I'm going after my dreams, I'm going after my life, like, this is just the surface. This is just really the surface. And there is so much deep down that I've been holding back. Because of like the pain, really the pain from childhood, right? And one thing I realized is that in the past 3 days is I realized that we don't have to continue to carry the baggage of the pain that our parents pass it down to us, right? Because our parents may not have the emotional intelligence to have intimate relationship with each other, so that maybe they didn't know how to be intimate with you. That created a whole story that you tell yourself that I'm not good enough because my mom wasn't intimate with me, because my mom didn't show me affection. There must be something wrong with me. You don't get to continue to carry that weight. Like, I realized how much weight I was carrying from my mom's pain, from my dad's pain, and it became a part of me. And that's been like the launching off place where I am creating everything. Everything that I do, everything that I did up until this point, I was making a decision coming from a place of, how can I avoid not feeling pain? How can I avoid not feeling fear? It was always coming from a place of lack. It was always coming from a place of insecurities and fear. And I am so ready. Like, I am so ready to let all of that go and just fully stepping into my power. And we need more people doing this work. We need so many more people owning up to their own shit and really, like, 100% being responsible for what they're creating. So I'll keep you guys updated. I'm gonna hop back off from... Daniela, thank you so much for your support. So I'm gonna hop back off from Facebook. Now, I made a commitment to myself in the past 3 days that I'm not gonna hold back anymore. Hi, Kirby. That, like, my voice, I've been shutting down my voice for so long because of fears of rejection, because of fears of, like, disapproval. I'm no longer gonna do that. So that's why I actually hopped on here. Initially, I didn't want to come on social media until, like, I ground myself, I center myself, but then I wanted to say something. I committed myself to just say it. I'm not going to pause. I'm not going to think about it. I'm not going to... And that's me stepping into my power. That's me really challenging, pushing beyond those limits. So that's why I'm here. And I am... Just remember, I hope, like, whatever's resonating with you, let me know in the comments below, and I'll see you guys again, I think, like, maybe Monday. So sending so much love from my heart to you guys. Take care. Talk to you soon.